Hello friends, today we will see how to load the talent profile data. So we'll load the language as part of talent profile data. So first we will see the navigation for the talent profile for any particular person. So for that we will navigate to the person management, query any of the person, then open the employment page for that particular person. Once employment page has been opened, then navigate to the talent profile. So you can find the talent profile option in person and employment page. Then here you can see several sections are there. So as part of talent profile, first we will see how to load the languages for this particular person, right? So for that, we require the talent profile and profile item, these two metadata, to load the talent profile data for any of the particular employee. So it has the description, summary, profile code, profile status code, profile type code, profile usage code, and the person ID, which we will pass as a surrogate ID for that particular employee, right? Then next is the profile item. So in that we will pass the profile ID as a surrogate source system ID. Then content type, content name, sections, then date to, date from. So here you can find this different sections are there, right? So as we are loading the languages, so we'll see the language is, so you will see the item catalog for the languages. So we'll open the profile options in my client group. So open the profiles. So in that, navigate to the item catalogs. So here in template yellow, you can find the languages. So you will get the languages item catalog. Click on the item catalogs. So here you can find several list of values defined in the language. So we are going to load the Hindi. So search for the Hindi language over here. So open that particular Hindi language. So here you can find this particular content item is tagged to the rating model as it's a language. So it is tagged to the rating model. So here some rating levels are defined. So you can find we are passing the rating model code and the rating model rating levels in our SDLs. So these are nothing but our these levels. So if we are passing the moderate, low, high, so depending on our proficiency, we will send the details. So first we will prepare the talent profile. So to load the talent profile, first we have to check if that talent profile is already created for that particular employee or not. Right? So first step is to check the talent profile is already created for that particular employee or not. So if So if talent profile is not created, then we will create the talent profile also with the profile item. And if the talent profile is already created in the system, then we will just load the profile item for that particular person. So because we are not going to load the talent profile in that case, because talent profile is already there, right? So we will just create the profile item in that case. So for loading the profile item, we will use the person ID as a surrogate ID for loading the talent profile item. So first we will check if the talent profile is already available for that person or not. For that we will go to the data model. We will check for one of the employee having employee number has XX test 2, which is the person number. So we'll check for this person if talent profile is already there or not. So we'll create such just a simple data set. So query the select star from per all people to get the person number, person ID from the person number. So we'll query per all people where person number is equal to XX test 2. So using this query, we will get the person ID. So we'll note down the person ID, which we are using in our SDL. So we'll note down the person ID. So now we can find any talent profile is created against this person ID or not. So for that we are using person ID, then we'll pass that particular person ID and find in one of the table called as HRT underscore profiles underscore B. So this is the table where we can find all the profiles tagged to the name of the person. So we'll find out the if talent profile is already created or not. So here you can see no talent profile is created for this person. So we have to create the talent profile as well as the profile item for this person, right? So we'll create the talent profile first. So we'll prepare the SDLs for talent profile. And then after that, once we are done with the talent profile, then we will do it for profile item, right? So here you can see first is metadata, then object name, then profile type code we need to pass. So profile type code you can pass the profile type code. We are passing as person over here. Then pass the profile code, profile status code. So as we know, we are creating the profile at person level. So we'll tag this particular profile type code as a person, which will be in caps for this particular person. So we'll create the SDLs as merge, then object name as source system owner as XX test, then source system ID will give the XX test talent 1 or 2, right? Then description, if you have the description, you can mention the description. Then after that, summary, if you have the summary, then mention the summary. If else, you can mention the next attribute, which is the profile type code, which is the person. Then mention the profile code. Profile code is nothing but the name of that particular profile. So you can give any unique name for this profile code. So here I am using person underscore talent as profile code. Then profile status code, we are creating this profile as an inactive status. So we'll set profile status code as active, then profile usage code as P, and person ID, which is the surrogate ID for this talent profile. So we have noted down the person ID. So we'll use the same person ID, right? So in this way, we have created the talent profile. So now we'll create the profile item for this talent profile. So for profile item, first we require, if we look at the SDL attributes, first we'll require the section name, right? So if you see, first we require the section name. So how to identify the section name for the languages, right? We are loading the languages, so we have to find the section name for languages. So we will query the table, which is HRT underscore profile underscore type underscore sections underscore VL. So we'll query this table, and as we are looking for the languages, so we'll put where condition as name is equal to languages. So if you see here, we'll get several different rows for the languages sections. So if you see, so from second to fourth, you can see they have mentioned that parent section ID as 1501. So it means parent section is 1501. So we'll use this section name as in our SDL. So for the section name, we have to take the section context column as a section name in SDLs. So copy the value for the section context, which is the person language. So copy that value. So we are providing the person language as a section name in our HDL. So we have copied that value. Then after that, after once we have decided the section, then note down the content type ID. So content type ID is 100. So 100 we noted down as 100 because we have to now identify content type for this particular section, right? So using content type ID 100, we will find the content type for that particular section. So for that, the table is HRT content types B, and we have the content type ID, so we will pass the content type ID as 100. So we'll get single row for this. So here again, we need the content type. So content type we are passing, we can get the value for content type value from the context name column from the backend, which is the language. So we are passing the language as a content type in HDL, right? And content atom, we are passing content atom as, we are loading the Hindi language, so content atom will pass it as Hindi language, right? Then rating model, as we have seen the rating model, these languages are tagged to the rating model, right? So language having the rating model, so we'll pass the rating model, its rating model code and the rating model level. Oh, sorry, rating levels and rating model code. Right. So we are passing the three values for rating model code and rating model level. Because if you see at front end, whenever a rating model has been defined, so it is mentioned that there are navigation options for the proficiency in reading, writing and speaking. So we are providing the values for reading, then writing and speaking. That's the reason we are giving the rating model code three times in the HDLs, right? Now rating model level, as we have seen, you are proficient, then you can pass high value as a rating model level, and rating model code is language for the languages. So likewise, we can prepare the profile item over here. So first metadata is our merge. Then after merge, object name is the profile item. Then use the source system owner, appropriate source system owner. Then create the source system ID, which is the unique one for this particular profile item. Then profile ID to get the reference from the talent profile. So we are use the source system ID of that profile. Then we are using the content type as a language, we have noted it down. Then content atom, as I said, we are going to load the Hindi language. So we'll use the content atom as Hindi, right? So we'll use profile atom. We are loading the profile atom for Hindi. So we'll use Hindi as content atom over here. So we'll use the content item as Hindi. Then section name. So we have noted down the section name as person language. So you can note it down, person language. Then country code. If you have the country code, you can mention it over here. Date from which date you want to create this profile item. So we are creating as on today's date. Then date 2. If you want to enter any date to, then you can mention it over here. Then mention the rating model codes and rating model levels as per the proficiency in reading, writing and speaking, right? So first rating model code, we are using languages. Then second rating model code for the writing, for which is the languages, and for third, which is the speaking category, so we'll use language, and we'll pass all the three categories as proficient for Hindi. So we'll pass the levels as high for all these three categories, reading, writing and speaking. So now we have done with our profile, talent profile and profile item. Now you can save this particular and make it the zip file. Once you have made the zip file, then import this particular zip file using the data exchange menu. So import that particular zip file. Click on the import. Choose your profile zip file, import. Select the option, file action option as import and load, because we want to load as well. Then submit this import and load data. So now our request has been submitted successfully. All right. So you can refresh this particular page to get that status of the talent profile.zip file over here. So you can find our talent profile is in import status. So import status is in progress. So we'll wait for a while to get it import. We can refresh it. So if you see, after refresh, you can see our file has been successfully imported. Right? So it means our file doesn't have any syntactic errors in our file. So that's the reason it successfully imported. Right? So we'll wait for a while to get it loaded into the system. Then we can refresh to check whether it is loaded or not. So we'll refresh it once again. Still its loading is in process. So here you can find our file has been successfully loaded into the Fusion instance. Now we can verify that XX test 2 person has languages loaded into the system or not. We have loaded the Hindi language. So we'll navigate to the person management to open that XX test 2 person for which we have loaded this profile and profile item. So navigate to the person management, query that our person, which is XX test 2. So we'll query that person. Open the employment page for this person. Once employment page is open, then go to the task pane, open the talent profile. So in language section, you can see our Hindi language is loaded successfully for this particular item. And here we can see for reading, we are giving the level as high for speaking as well and writing as well, right? So it means our talent profile has been successfully loaded into the system. So in this way, you can section to load the talent profiles. Thank you.